Hi, I am Anash P. Uman with the Google Developer Relations team. This screencast will show you how to get started with the AdWords API .NET client library. The library requires Microsoft .NET Runtime version 2.0. The library also works on Mono version 2.4.4. The library depends on system.configuration, system.xml, system.web, and system.web.services runtime assemblies. It doesn't depend on any third-party assemblies. The first thing you need to do is to download the library. The best way to find it is just to go to the AdWords API documentation at code.google.com/api/AdWords. From here, click on Docs and then on Client Libraries and click on .NET Client Library. This is the main project page of the AdWords API .NET Client Library. On the left bottom side of the page are links to download the latest version of the library. Now click the link to download the latest version of the library. Once you have downloaded the library, extract it to the folder of your choice. The library distribution contains docs, examples in C# and VB for various API versions, a precompiled version of the assembly, and solution files for various versions of Visual Studio. Open the AdWords.sln in Visual Studio. The solution consists of one project each for C# examples, VB examples, and auth. Both C# and VB example project consist of code examples for all the major API versions. Auth code example is designed as an ASP.NET website that retrieves all the campaigns from a user's account. Before you can run the code examples, you need to fill in the AdWords credential in your application's app.config or a website's web.config. Let's do it for adwords.examples.c#. Open the app.config. We will run the code examples against the AdWords API sandbox. Details on how to use the AdWords API sandbox is available at code.google.com/apis/adwords/docs/sandbox.html. When using the sandbox, your client email is client_n plus your email address, where n can be from 1 to 5. Your developer token is your Google account plus currency code. For example, john.doe@gmail.com++USD. The email and password is your Google account email address /password. You also need to change the AdWords API server URL to https://adwords.sandbox.google.com. Note that the client library uses two different keys for configuring the AdWords API server URLs. For V13 API, it uses a key named legacy-adwords-api.server, and for other versions of the API, it uses a key named adwords-api.server. Make sure you set both keys appropriately when making calls to the AdWords API sandbox. The sandbox needs to be initialized by running the getAllCampaigns example. You can run a code example by setting the example name as a command line argument for the code examples project. To run the v2011.01 version of getAllCampaigns, you need to set v2011.getAllCampaigns as the command line argument. Now run the code example. The code example returns an empty list. This is to be expected since the sandbox is initially empty and you have to populate it with campaigns, ad groups, etc. to use it. Let's create a new campaign by running the @campaign code example. Set the command line argument to v2011.addCampaign and run the code example. This creates a new campaign and displays the campaign ID and name. Now run the getAllCampaigns again. The code example now returns the campaign you created. Let's now build a simple AdWords application to get a better understanding of the library and its use. Our sample application is a console application that retrieves a list of campaigns for a user and prints the list to console. Note that though this video shows a console project for brevity, you can follow similar steps to build a Windows form application or an ASP.NET website. Let's start by creating a new console application. Now copy the lib folder from AdWords API.NET client library distribution into your projects folder. Then add a reference to lib/google.adwords.dll in your project. Also add reference to assemblies system.xml, system.web, system.configuration and system.web.services. Now add an application configuration file to your project. Now open examples/c-sharp/app.config from the AdWords API.NET library distribution and copy its contents into your app.config file. In case your app.config already have other content, then merge its content with the values of app.config. Now fill your credentials in the app.config. Let's start developing our application. We will start by defining an AdWords user object in our main method. AdWords user is the entry point to the library and allows you to create services for making AdWords API call. The AdWords user provides two constructors. The first one creates an AdWords user object with credentials mentioned in your app.config. If you want to set credentials at the runtime instead of specifying them in your app.config, then you can use the overloaded AdWords user constructor. You can also modify a user object after its creation by setting appropriate configuration parameters through the user's config property. Let's add the functionality to retrieve and display all the campaigns. We will start by getting an instance of v2001 campaign service using the getService method of AdWords user. This call creates a campaign service object configured with the current settings of the user object. You can also modify an existing service object's configuration by modifying its request header property. Now, create a selector and set the fields we want to retrieve. Now call the campaign service.get method to get the campaigns. You will get back a campaign page object and its entries field hold the list of campaigns. You can loop through them and display the results. Now run our application. As expected, the application displays the list of all campaigns. AdWords API services throw exceptions whenever something goes wrong at its end. Let's add some error handling to our application. The two most common exceptions thrown by an AdWords API server are auth token exception and AdWords API exception. An AdWords API exception gets thrown whenever the AdWords API server throws an error. The API exception field of AdWords API exception object holds the underlying API exception. The API exception object in turn may contain one or more errors which need to be handled appropriately. An auth token exception gets thrown whenever the service fails to retrieve an auth token using the client login API. The details of the error can be found in the error code field of auth token exception object. Let's trigger these exceptions to check our code. To trigger an auth token exception, let's set a bad user password. Now run the application. As expected, our application handles the auth token exception thrown by the server and prints an error message. Now let's trigger an AdWords API exception by setting a bad client email login. Now run the application. As expected, our application handles the AdWords API exception thrown by the server and displays an appropriate error message. This concludes the Getting Started video for the AdWords API .NET client library. If you have more questions, feel free to ask them on our forum at groups.google.com/group/AdWords-API.